In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Today is the feast day of the ancient Persian, today we would say Iranian martyrs, Abdin and Senen. They were arrested under the Emperor Dacius, and having refused to worship idols in their native land, were taken in chains all the way from Persia to Rome, and they were exposed to the wild beasts, who did not dare to touch them, and then finally they were themselves cut apart with swords, and their bodies dragged for the idol of the sun, which they had refused to worship in their native land. A deacon named Cyrenus came and took their bodies away and buried them in one of the ancient Roman catacombs. And in Rome, there was in the old days a very great devotion to these saints, as well as a church above ground that was built in their honor. I thought of these things just last night when I was reading yesterday's paper. We had commemorated them already at the Vespers. And here, these two wonderful saints were from what is today the country of Iran, and how up-to-date, you might say, how relevant they would say today, I suppose, are our saints. That is to say, that with all of the turbulence in that country, there are many prisoners right now who are themselves being tortured and treated in the most disgusting fashion by their own rulers. And all of this, unfortunately, is not for the service of the true God, but is only because they want some political candidate to be president instead of another. I truly pray for the conversion of this country, which has given to the church so many glorious martyrs down throughout the centuries, and for the end of all this wasted blood and cruelty and sin, that may God rather be glorified in them. So let us confide to these two holy martyrs, Saints Abdin and Senen, the conversion of their native land of Iran, and the conversion of Rome, and the conversion of our own hearts as well. The martyrs who shed their precious blood, united it with the precious blood of Jesus, which has just now been offered at the holy sacrifice of the Mass. And that blood is all of our strength and all of our life and all of our hope. We'll kneel down and we'll say a prayer in their honor and for the precious blood. Hearken to our earnest prayers, O blessed martyrs. May the faith at length triumph in that land of Iran, when so many flowers of martyrdom have been culled for heaven. Before the time appointed for the struggle to begin in your own native land, ye went forth to meet death elsewhere, and thus gained a new fatherland whereon to bestow your love. Bless us, fellow citizens of your choice, and bring us all to the eternal fatherland of all the children of God. Amen. By the shedding of the blood of Christ our Lord, peace has been established in heaven and earth. Oh, truly precious is the covenant of peace, which was made by the offering of that holy blood, not with gold, nor silver, nor gems, nor pearls, but with the blood that gushed from the side of the Savior. That bloodshedding gladdened heaven, purified earth, and terrified hell. Precious blood of Jesus, save us. Thou hast redeemed us, O Lord, in thy blood, and made us for our God a kingdom. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who didst appoint thine only begotten Son, Redeemer of the world, and willed to be appeased by his blood, grant we beseech thee, that we may so honor this, the price of our redemption, and by its virtue be defended from the evils of our present life on earth, as to enjoy its fruits in heaven forevermore, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal Father, I offer thee the precious blood of Jesus in satisfaction for my sins and for the wants of Holy Church. Saints Abdin and Senen, pray for us, and we conclude by reciting the Angelus.